Difficult. What to do with you, hot dog? You clearly don't belong in Sandwich House. And it would be absurd to place you in Taco House. Yeah, I guess you'll join Hufflepuff.
Ah, oh, man.
Internet, welcome to Food Theory, where we show you how the sausage gets made, and then we show you how it's classified. If there's one food that's inextricably linked to American summertime celebrations, it's the hot dog. If the sun's out, buns are out, and you'll find Americans buying them, grilling them, and cheering on professional eaters as they consume impossible amounts of them. Americans didn't invent the wiener, Americans didn't invent the bun, but I'll be darned if Americans weren't the first to put a wiener on a bun, which is all we need to do to lay claim to the invention of the hot dog. When hot dogs first came onto the scene in 1860s New York, few could have appreciated the classification quagmire they'd eventually create. I mean, when you get down to it, what is a hot dog? Is it a sandwich? Is it technically a taco? Or is a hot dog its own thing altogether? Where exactly in the food classification diagram does this unholy creation lie? This might seem trivial to you, but this is no joke here, people. These questions have been swirling around since hot dogs first came onto the scene, and the debate is only picking up steam in the internet age. People are arguing about it on Reddit, on Twitter. People are making alignment charts about this issue, for crying out loud. If you ask me, an argument of this level of importance calls for a ruling from the highest court in the land, the U.S. Supreme Court. Luckily, we got exactly that in 2018 when Stephen Colbert talked to the notorious RBG. That's Ruth Bader Ginsburg.
Is a hot dog a sandwich?
Well, you tell me what a sandwich is, and then I'll tell you if a hot dog is a sandwich.
Two pieces of bread with almost any type of filling in between, as long as it's not more bread.
On your definition, yes it is.
Circular reasoning much? It doesn't help us at all. Ruth is essentially saying a hot dog is a sandwich if you define sandwich in a way that would describe a hot dog. Which means it's back in our hands, folks, the common people. The people who today are gonna have to dig a little bit deeper if we wanna get to the doggone truth once and for all. Is a hot dog a sandwich? Right off the bat, it's important to recognize it's the definition of sandwich that's so difficult to pin down here, not the definition of hot dog. Hot dogs aren't complicated. We all know what a hot dog is. It's A, a wiener, B, laid lengthwise on a bun, and C, the wiener is filled with something resembling meat that no one can ever entirely vouch for. Furthermore, the proper authorities have assertively stepped up to the plate with clear rules regarding hot dog etiquette. According to the National Hot Dog and Sausage Council, and I must say I'm both surprised and comforted to learn such an authoritative body exists, mustard, relish, onions, cheese, and chili are all acceptable wiener toppings. And that's the end of their list. Ketchup is not on that list. Mayo is definitely not on that list. So there you have it, friends. The hot dog comes with clear guidelines, definitions, rules of etiquette. That is some strong and strangely decisive leadership from the National Hot Dog and Sausage Council. But when it comes to the world of sandwiches, guys, let me tell you, it is chaos. The freewheeling sandwich community is leaderless and rudderless. Now, I say that as a joke, but also it's not really a joke, because there is, in fact, a National Sandwich Council of America, but these wannabes ain't moving the needle anytime soon. The National Sandwich Council of America's Facebook profile, and yes, they have a profile, as opposed to a proper branded page, has exactly 122 likes. They last posted in 2014, and to date have received 3 likes for their efforts, which is so frustrating to me because the world is desperate for someone in this world to seize control and expertly guide the sandwich narrative, the same way that the National Hot Dog and Sausage Council over there has done for hot dogs. But alas, the National Sandwich Council of America appears to have lost their Facebook password and my remaining respect. Now, you may be thinking to yourself, who needs an organization to do any of this? I can define a sandwich, no sweat. I know what a sandwich is. To which I say, do you? Do you? Do you really? Sure. It's a bunch of ingredients, usually meat, cheese, and or vegetables, between 2 slices of bread, and that's all fine and dandy. But what about open-faced sandwiches, where you just spread peanut butter and jelly on a single slice of bread and eat it like a piece of toast? And if simply spreading something on a slice of bread makes it a sandwich, does that mean that when I butter my toast in the morning, that I'm making an open-faced butter sandwich? By that logic, is a pizza an open-faced sandwich? It's bread with toppings. What if I have meat, cheese, and lettuce, but smush them between 2 hamburgers? Burger buns, or two halves of a bagel, or two tortillas? Is a quesadilla a sandwich? Is a chicken wrap a sandwich? Is a taco a sandwich? Is the KFC double down, in which the bread is swapped out for two pieces of fried chicken, the most American thing to come out of America, a sandwich? So I think you're starting to see what we're dealing with here. It's a slippery slope, a sloppery joke, if you will. Granted, sandwich is a broad term, and a lot of variations are meant to fall under its umbrella, but there's no sandwich council stepping up to offer definitive answers as to what exactly that umbrella covers. Since Supreme Court justices are punting on the issue, it's gonna take some footwork to hunt down the authoritative definition of sandwich. Once we have the proper definition of sandwich, then, and only then, will we be able to answer the question that gnaws at us, driving me mad. The question that's driving us mad: is a hot dog a sandwich? Given that the hot dog is an all-American creation, we should check to see if hot dogs meet America's own definition of a sandwich. Time to go straight to the source, the U.S. Department of Agriculture. These are guys who know their stuff when it comes to foodstuffs. According to Mark Wheeler, who works in food and safety at the USDA, quote, "A sandwich is a meat or poultry filling between two slices of bread, a bun, or a biscuit," end quote. That definition comes from the USDA's Food Standards and Labeling Policy Book. But that doesn't mean I'm happy about it. So, I have a couple issues with this old quote here. Folks, I'm over here trying to determine if a hot dog is a sandwich. Meanwhile, the USDA over there is pooping out half-baked phrases like, "A sandwich is a meat or poultry filling." Really, USDA? Meat or poultry? Come on, poultry, being domestic fowl like chicken or turkey, duck, geese, pheasant, if you want to get all fancy, is already included in the definition of meat. Not all meat is poultry, but certainly all poultry is meat. You shouldn't need to specify meat or poultry because poultry is already included in the definition of the word meat. And are we just gonna gloss over the fact that their definition of sandwich doesn't allow for the existence of sandwiches without meat or poultry? Sorry, vegetarians, according to the USDA, anything that you could eat is, by definition, not a sandwich. The schoolyard lunch classic of peanut butter and jelly? Not a sandwich, apparently. Avocado, lettuce, tomato, and French dressing between two slices of bread? Not a sandwich. The legendary grilled cheese? Not a sandwich. Okay, I'm gonna nip this rant in the bud right now, but I gotta say, it's beginning to feel like the powers that be don't want this all-important question to be answered. But hey, that's just a theory. A conspiracy theory. Really, though, is hot dog classification just a joke to these people? Because I'm over here taking it very seriously. Very, very seriously. Maybe I'm taking it too seriously. At any rate, by the USDA's definition, a hot dog is, in fact, classified as a sandwich. But more importantly, it turns out that the USDA might not be the most authoritative organization on the block where sandwich is concerned. You see, the USDA is only responsible for the labeling of meat, poultry, and egg products. Food products that don't include meat, poultry, or egg are under the jurisdiction of the Food and Drug Administration, the FDA, and not the U.S. Department of Agriculture. So this explains why the USDA's definition seemed so meat-centric. It's also an important reminder, when you ask for definitions, it matters a lot who you're asking. Ask a government department that only deals with meat, and they'll probably give you a definition that only cares about the cases involving meat. Though, I do have to take issue with the fact that the U.S. Department of Agriculture doesn't include egg salad sandwiches in their definition of sandwich, despite the fact that eggs are supposedly also one of their things. Clearly, if we want a definition that includes non-meat matters, like that classic grilled cheese that we all know should qualify as a sandwich, we should seek out a better source of information. Sorry for doubting your sandwichhood, grilled cheese. I sincerely apologize, but it has to be done in the name of science. Maybe we should pull our definition from an authority whose scope is a little bit broader, not someone who's so laser-focused on meat. Let me think. What's a government authority who's got their fingers in everyone else's business? Why don't we try the tax man? It's like the Beatles told us in their classic song, you drive a car, they'll tax the street. You try to sit, they'll tax your seat. You get too cold, they'll tax the heat. And if you take a walk, they'll tax your feet. Now, obviously that's an exaggeration. At least, I don't think I've ever had to declare my footsies when filing my taxes. But here's something that's not an exaggeration. New York State has a document titled Tax Bulletin ST-835. What is considered a sandwich? And remember, New York is where the hot dog was invented, so I'm definitely curious to know where they land on the issue. Now, if you're wondering why the Department of Revenue would be concerned with the legal definition of a sandwich, it mostly comes down to the fact that while the state taxes prepared food, like what you'd get from a restaurant, it doesn't have a sales tax for unprepared foods that you buy at a grocery store. McDouble, McChicken, both taxed. Uncooked hamburger and chicken patties from the frozen food section at your grocery store store, not taxed. In short, buying food ingredients isn't supposed to carry a tax, but that changes when you get into prepared food, which some grocery stores do sell. And the state wants to make sure that whenever you pick up a pre-made sandwich, it's labeled as such because sandwiches will fall into the category of prepared foods and they need to be making money off of that sale. Also, if you're tricky and looking to avoid taxes, this does mean that there's a loophole in the tax code. A sandwich is taxed, but the same ingredients, if separated, are not taxed. One home delivery service took advantage of this by selling chicken tortilla wraps that all came unassembled. Instead of selling the wrap, they would provide customers with the tortilla, some chicken, and vegetables, and then let them assemble it themselves. Turns out, they got away with it too. The state ruled that they didn't have to pay the tax for prepared food because the food wasn't prepared. They were just selling a collection of ingredients. It's a good thing that they found that loophole too, because it turns out a chicken tortilla wrap is exactly the kind of thing that the state of New York would include in their definition of a sandwich. According to that tax bulletin I mentioned before, a sandwich is, quote, made on bread or on bagels, on rolls, in pitas, in wraps or otherwise, and regardless of the filling or the number of layers. Now that is a pretty broad definition. That's a definition that, again, encompasses hot dogs. But here's the thing. According to the state of New York, a Chipotle burrito is also a sandwich. And since this definition is meant to be applied regardless of the filling, it means that it doesn't matter if your sandwich is meat or vegan, sweet or savory. It also applies regardless of the number of layers, which means that an open-faced sandwich is a sandwich. So is a bagel with cream cheese a sandwich? Yes. Is a bagel with lox on it a sandwich? Yes. Heck, by this definition, a pizza is a sandwich. When left in the hands of tax regulators, it would seem the definition of sandwich can go completely off the rails. According to one tax regulation in the state of Colorado, quote, sandwiches are defined as single-serving items such as hamburgers, hot dogs, frozen pizzas, burritos, chicken wings, etc. I mean, it's so dumb. It's so stupid. I've heard some whoppers in my day, but can we at least agree that a chicken wing is not a sandwich? I don't know. Maybe those Beatles weren't exaggerating after all. Maybe I should start talking to my accountant to make sure I don't have to declare my feet as some sort of tax write-off. But the takeaway here is that once again, we need to consider the source where our definition is coming from. It behooves the USDA to focus on meat when defining a sandwich. It behooves the Department of Revenue to define anything as a sandwich because more taxes mean that they get to collect more money. Gotta say, I'm feeling a bit like Goldilocks right now. I found a definition that's too narrow. I found one that's too broad. Now I want one that's just right. But who to trust? Which individuals or organizations out there are most in tune with how real people are using the term sandwich in real life? Me, I'm thinking restaurants. After all, you can define the word sandwich however you want in legalese when it comes to writing tax law, apparently to the point of including chicken wings in your definition of sandwich, but if you put chicken wings on the menu and call it a sandwich, real-life customers aren't gonna let you get away with that one. And if we can get a legal authority to rule on how restaurants do business, even better. Fortunately, that ruling came from a court in Worcester County, Massachusetts. If you're wondering how something like this goes to court, the story goes a little something like this. Shopping centers often have agreements with restaurants that operate in that shopping center that they won't lease out space to restaurants of the same type. The basic rationale for this is that if two Italian restaurants open right next to one another, they'll just end up competing each other out of business, which is bad for the restaurants and also bad for the shopping center who has to now find a new renter to replace the restaurant that goes out of business. On top of that, it's nice for the regular shoppers if they have more dining options when they visit. Imagine going to a food court and all they got is Chinese restaurants. Got nothing against Chinese food, but like a little bit more variety, you know? Anyway, two similar restaurants opening in the same shopping center would be a lose-lose-lose for everyone involved, which is why a Massachusetts Panera location had an agreement with its shopping center that the Panera would be the only sandwich place in that center. No Subway, no Quiznos. Essentially, Panera had a monopoly on the sandwich rights to that shopping center. Things got a bit sticky, though, when a Qdoba tried to move in. The owners of the Panera Bread claimed that having a Qdoba restaurant next door would violate their lease agreement. Somehow, a Mexican restaurant serving burritos was seen by the Panera owners as a threat to their sandwich monopoly. Now, I think a lot of us would say, of course Qdoba isn't a sandwich place, they serve tacos and burritos. But as we've just seen, according to tax boards across the land, the definition of the word sandwich often includes things like wraps and burritos. So, was Qdoba infringing on Panera's turf by trying to sell tortillas filled with beans, rice, and meat? Well, that ended up being settled in court. Like any good court case, expert witnesses were called in to testify in order for the judge to make an informed decision. One of those witnesses was Cambridge chef and food writer Christopher Schlesinger, who said, quote, I know of no chef or culinary historian who would call a burrito a sandwich. Indeed, the notion would be absurd to any credible chef or culinary historian, end quote. And the judge, Justice Jeffrey A. Locke, ultimately agreed. He ruled in favor of Qdoba being allowed to operate in the same shopping center as the Panera. In his decision, he cited an entry in Merriam-Webster's dictionary as one of the most compelling pieces of evidence. Quoting the justice himself, the new Webster Third International Dictionary describes a sandwich as two thin pieces of bread, usually buttered, with a thin layer as of meat, cheese, or savory mixture spread between them. Under this definition, and as dictated by common sense, this court finds that the term sandwich is not commonly understood to include burritos, tacos, and quesadillas. And as for hot dogs? According to the definition acknowledged by the court, a hot dog is, drumroll please, not a sandwich. A hot dog does not have two pieces of bread. It has one. That piece of bread is not typically buttered. The layer of meat in a hot dog is not thin. It's tubular. And a hot dog wiener does not get spread across the bread. So there you have it, friends. A ruling from the Massachusetts Superior Court. Stamp this hot take food theory certified fresh. Hot dogs are not sandwiches. They're their own all-American thing. And Panera didn't appeal the court case either, so the matter remains settled there, or so we'd like to think. Because keep in mind, the judge cited the dictionary definition of a sandwich. Dictionaries change every year to reflect the way that we use language. The word emoji and meme weren't in the Merriam-Webster dictionary 10 years ago, and now they are. Along with other words like jegging. Remember that short-lived fashion trend? I don't, but the dictionary does. The judge also cited common sense, which is another thing that changes over time. After all, common sense used to say that lots of grains were the foundation of any healthy diet. Remember that food pyramid that we were all taught back in school? And now most diet advice warns us against the dangers of having too many carbs. The point is, if the definition of a sandwich is going to be based on things like the dictionary definition, which is based on how people use language, and common sense, which is even more nebulous, the definition of what is or isn't a sandwich could change the moment that we as a society collectively decide that the old definition is obsolete. Language is a democracy. If enough people decide that a word means something, the dictionaries update to reflect it. And personally, I find it fitting that the all-American hot dog got classified democratically in the end. But hey, that's just a theory. A food theory. Okay, so I know I've been pushing the whole subscribe thing on you hard across these 5 videos. I'm just so excited to have Food Theory grow and find its stride. It is scary launching a new channel. It's especially scary launching a new channel here in 2020, and knowing that you guys are excited about it, knowing that you're here to join me to nerd out about a whole new content category of video, that's really awesome. I would love to nerd out with you about everything food related. I'm just really excited for Food Theory to grow and find its stride, just like Game Theory and Film Theory have. We'd love to have your support as we strike out into the world of food-centric edutainment. So subscribe, check out our other fantastic episodes, and then subscribe again. Wait, actually don't do that, because clicking twice would unsubscribe you. Listen, hit the subscribe button an odd amount of times, and I promise to stop pushing it so hard on you, okay? If you hit it now, chances are, like, 5 videos from now, I will stop talking about it. But until then, please subscribe, please. Please, 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 please subscribe. I'm on my knees. I'm on my digital knees. Actually, that is true. I record sitting on my knees. It's probably not good for them. I should probably not do that.